You think he remembers?
He can't.
You did.
You went through my stuff.
We need to talk.
This isn't about the code or feeding your urges. This is vengeance.
Yep.
Hey guys, Pete here. Today I'm going to talk about the trailer for episode 5 of Dexter New Blood. There's also some interesting promo photos, and all of that, along with the episode synopsis, gives us an idea of what to expect. I'm going to get into all of that, and then I'll talk about some general theories for the season. First, a quick spoiler warning. If you're not caught up through episode 4, or if you don't like promotional material and speculation about that, then this video won't be for you. And with that out of the way, let's get into it. Episode 5 is titled Runaway, which is the song by Del Shannon we heard during the laser scope killer scene where he released Lily from the basement and shot her as she tried to run away. And the episode description reads, Dexter's method of protecting his son from drugs unleashes his dark passenger in a very impulsive way. Meanwhile, Angela and Molly take a trip to New York City that leaves them wondering about a well-respected member of the community. Harrison has mentioned that he has a history with drugs, but he got clean a couple of years ago. And in the episode 5 trailer, we see him arrive at a party where it looks like he's getting ready to relapse. And in one of the promo photos, it does show him in the hospital with Dexter coming to visit, so things might go south for him in a hurry. The Angela and Molly part might indicate that they'll be wondering about Kurt, since that's where he told them Matt was whenever they had the FaceTime call, and they certainly won't be able to find him there. The trailer opens with a shot of Rita in the bathtub, at least her hand, because we see it from a young Harrison's perspective. As he's looking at the straight razor, Deb asks her brother, "Do you think he remembers?" He says that he can't. As in, he's too young to remember. Dexter was a little older when he witnessed his mother's death, but he did remember, and it shaped his life. And they're trying to decide if the same thing's going on with Harrison. We know he found the razor, and we see him looking at it here, and it looks like he's going to confront him right away. I'm glad to see that. I'm glad they're not letting that linger. And it looks like Harrison is upset. He says, "You look through my stuff." So there's a violation of trust there, but also he's trying to hide the fact that he has this thing, and he's lying about what happened with Ethan. This could be the catalyst for him going out. Maybe he gets angry at Dexter and then he wants to go hang out and party, and then maybe that lands him in the hospital. Right after that, Dexter is outside somebody's house stalking them. And it's probably a drug house. We see someone we don't recognize coming out of the front door. And then later in the trailer, we see this same red door getting knocked down by the police. We hear Deb and Dexter talking again. And she says, "This isn't about the code or feeding your urges. This is about vengeance." And he quickly comes back saying yes. It would make sense if Harrison OD'd, or he got some bad drugs and ended up in the hospital, or whatever the story is. That might be enough to get Dexter to do something impulsive. And there's another promo photo where he's holding a syringe, and then of course at the end of the trailer we see he has someone on his table. So that all seems to track with that situation. And there's a couple of other shots in previous trailers that look like they come from this episode. In the New Blood official trailer, we saw more of the police busting into this house. There's this shot where there are drugs on the table and scales. It looks like a fairly serious dealer's house. And then someone is knotted out in the chair, and Logan, with gun drawn, comes in and checks this guy's pulse. And I hadn't thought this before, but is this Harrison? The hair looks like it could be, but I didn't notice a resemblance other than that. Going into the season, I wasn't expecting something like this to happen in Harrison's story. And in the behind-the-scenes trailer that they put out, we saw Dexter knock out this guy with a beanie and long hair. You don't get a great look at him, but it looks like he might be related to the drug storyline. He looks a little flashier than the average Iron Lake citizen. I can't make out where Molly and Angela are supposed to be in New York, but she does have that mention where she says, "Can you imagine being right next to a serial killer and having no idea?" Which is obviously Angela's situation. In one shot, we see Kurt in his kill outfit coming down the stairs. So maybe his ritual of getting the girl in the basement scared so that she'll run away isn't working with this new girl. There are a couple of shots of her in the room, and it looks like he's recreating the same situation. We see her looking at the camera and banging on the door, but seeing him come down into the basement in full gear is a deviation from his normal MO, which seems to be hunting them in the field behind the cabin. Then the trailer comes to an end with Dexter saying, "I think you lived long enough," to the person on his table. And you see that things are progressing. He's coming back to his old self. This new kill might be out of vengeance rather than following the code, but he was stalking. There are photos hung up on the wall, so he did some research. And overall, he looks better equipped and more in control of the situation. Having Dexter deviating from the code is a sort of return to a classic scenario, but where that could get interesting is in how that affects their developing relationship. If the drug-related stuff plays out like it looks like it will, that is a kind of darkness inside his son. I mentioned at the end of my last video that this idea of him having a dark passenger, it's basically the best case scenario for Dexter in relation to forming a bond with Harrison. I mean, it's terrible if your son has a compulsion to kill people, but it's also one of the few things that Dexter understands, an area where he feels like he has something to offer. So I'm still skeptical that Harrison has the same thing going on. I mean, obviously he slashed Ethan with a blade like Trinity used. He slashed him on the femoral artery, or at least tried to, like Trinity did. But I haven't reached the conclusion that this revival is about Dexter having a son that's just like him, that he needs to train up in Harry's code. It seems like presenting him as capable of violence works to set up some tension in the end, that he might be capable of killing Dexter, his own father. Dexter having to kill Harrison doesn't feel like a definitive ending for the main character, which is part of their stated reason for coming back and making a revival. Harrison killing Dexter doesn't necessarily sound great either, but it does make more sense in that regard. For that reason, there's drama built in, and from there you have options. And I'll come back to that in a minute. As far as the other big questions and theories for the rest of the season, I think it's clear now that Kurt is behind the missing girls and he's been doing that for a long time. It does sound like he's going to try to compensate for his loss of Matt by getting close to Harrison. At least that's what people who are involved with the show have said in interviews. And that will ultimately lead to one of them, Dexter or Harrison, figuring out what's going on with the girls. I think it's likely that Iris will turn out to be the first or one of the first girls he did this with, which would make it even more personal for Angela. And I did notice when I was rewatching the trailers, there's a shot of her going into the basement. So it looks like they will discover that place, but I don't know what episode that'll show up in. And that sets up a situation where Dexter is trying to end Kurt before the police can figure it out. One theory that I had seen thrown around a lot before this last episode was that the laser scope killer was Ed Olson, the billionaire, or that Kurt was kidnapping the girls and then Olson and or other rich guys were paying to hunt them. I mean, they did introduce Ed for a reason, so I see why people might go in this direction, but he seems to have a direct interest in Audrey, and that makes it feel more likely that he'll turn out to be her biological father, or something else related directly to her situation. Or perhaps, you know, he killed Iris. Iris could be her mother. That seems like a safe guess. So perhaps Ed killed her. And then what? I don't know. Kurt helped him cover it up. And then that's where Kurt developed this method or this obsession that he has now. It could get a little twisty there. But I think what would make the most sense is that he has this direct relationship with Audrey that she doesn't know about. Either way, I feel like Kurt is killing the girls. I think they cleared that up at this point. I think that part of the story now is just about why he does it and how he ends up on Dexter or Harrison's radar. There's definitely going to be a showdown coming between them. Another popular theory that seems to have been put to rest is the idea that maybe Harrison was an imposter. Maybe it's not really Dexter's son, but just someone pretending to be. I never liked this because it seemed like there was already a perfectly interesting story that doesn't need a twist if he is actually Harrison. If they were going with this theme of fathers and sons and really investigating this relationship between these two and how they get along after this crazy past that they share, why undermine that with a crazy twist at the end that would make it all for nothing? Story-wise, if this was Cody or one of his victims' relatives, from my perspective, that just really wouldn't be a great ending. And the further we get into it, it seems like everything's pointing to him being who he says he is. Did he kill Hannah? That's a popular idea that people have. I mean, maybe. It would certainly make things a lot more complicated for him getting out of Argentina and getting to where he's at right now. The actual story they gave him is a little hand-wavy to begin with, but I feel like this would definitely be another level of that. But I mean, maybe. He's shown that he can be impulsively violent. So if he found the letter and read it and realized that this had been hidden from him, it's possible, but it doesn't feel absolutely necessary, so we'll just have to wait and see. I think there's a lot of wild theories out there because they did a pretty good job of keeping things somewhat mysterious. When I think about the early seasons and when Dexter was really good, I think that has a lot more to do with tension and well-timed reveals rather than crazy twists. So when I think about what might happen here, I think of it through that lens, because one of the problems the series had as it went on was they were so good at creating that tension. After a while, it had a diminishing return because you can only think to yourself, oh my God, he's not going to get out of this. How is he not going to get caught? How is he not going to die? How is he not going to go to jail or whatever? So many times before you're like, okay, he never gets caught. He's never going to get killed and so on and so forth. So that's where I'm at right now. And I think that's a good place to leave things. Let me know in the comments what you're thinking, what you're hoping will happen, and what you want to see in the next episode and the rest of the season. Please like this video if you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. This got delayed a little bit because I had some other stuff going on, but next week I'll try to get this out sooner. And thanks for watching. I'll talk to you soon.